We're going to draw out all possible aldehyde and ketone isomers for C5H10O in this video. Have you tried out on your own? Well, stay tuned until the end of this video to compare notes. Let's begin. Quick recap. Aldehyde has a carbonyl functional group, which is C double bond O, connected right next to a hydrogen. Note that this CHO group is always at the first carbon for aldehyde, whereas for ketone, it has the same carbonyl group, but it's next to two carbons. So there's no hydrogen connected right next to the carbonyl group. That's the difference between aldehyde and ketone. Let's start with aldehyde. Since we have five carbons, let's place the CHO group at the beginning, and then we'll add in the remaining carbons in a row like this. That's our first aldehyde isomer, and that has five carbon chain, because we have five carbons straight in a row. Now, instead of placing all five carbons in a row, we can place four in a row. The fifth carbon is stuck on carbon two. Now let's keep the same framework of four carbon chain, and then we'll see if we can stick the fifth carbon elsewhere. In fact, we can place it on carbon three. This is different from the previous aldehyde, so that gives us our third aldehyde. And we're now done with four carbon chain, because if we were to stick the fifth carbon on carbon four, it will give us a five carbon chain, which is the same as our first structure. Now let's see what we can do with a 3-carbon chain aldehyde. We've used 3 carbon and 1 oxygen, so that means we have 2 carbon left. So let's stick the 2 carbons on carbon 2. That will give us yet another isomer. Now, similar to previous example, we don't want to stick anything at the end of the carbon chain, otherwise it will give us a repeat of what we have already drawn. Since we can't shorten the chain to 2 carbon, that means we are done with aldehyde. We fill up with the appropriate number of hydrogens, and that will give us these structures. Keep in mind that each carbon makes 4 bonds, and be sure to check that each structure has 10 hydrogens, no more and no less. Quick recap on how we drew all 4 isomers for aldehyde. We started with the longest chain, which is the 5 carbon chain, and then we move on to the 4 carbon chain. We stick the remaining carbon on C2, and then we draw another structure and place the remaining carbon on C3. Once we've exhausted the 4 carbon chain, we then shorten the chain further to 3 carbon chain, and then we stick the remaining 2 carbons on C2. Since we can't shorten the chain anymore, we know that we have already drawn out all isomers for aldehyde, and we did it in a very systematic way. This increases our probability for drawing all isomers correctly and with zero errors. Now, let's move on to ketone. Let's start by placing the carbonyl group sandwiched by 2 carbons. Since we're dealing with 5 carbons, let's place the remaining 2 carbons straight in a row, like this. And that will give us a 5 carbon chain ketone, with carbonyl group at C2. Let's keep working with this 5 carbon chain, and now we will move the carbonyl group to C3. That will give us another isomer. If we were to move the carbonyl group to carbon 4, it will actually be the same as the first structure. So let's move on to the 4 carbon chain now. Here's our 4 carbon chain, and then we will stick the 5th carbon on C3. Looks like there's only one way to stick the 5th carbon on a 4 carbon chain. If we were to stick the 5th carbon on C4, it will actually give us the same structure as the first ketone. Also, we can't shorten the chain to 3 carbon chain, so that means we're actually done drawing all ketones. Let's fill up the structure with remaining hydrogens, and here's what we got. Here are our 3 ketones. To recap, we have a total of 4 aldehydes and 3 ketones for C5H10O. If you're interested in drawing other isomers aside from aldehyde and ketone for C5H10O, let me know in the comments and I'll post a video for it. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.